Alright, so in this problem, we have a survey of 1,000 men that is, they're seeing who has male baldness or non-baldness. And people who are bald have the recessive allele for it, and people that are not bald have the dominant allele for it. So we know out of 1,000, we had 360 that were bald. So we know that 360 had the homozygous recessive. So 360.
Thank you.
Equals. So we have this, which basically translates into this, which is Q squared equals 360. Or Q squared equals 0.36, because 360 divided by 1,000 gives us a decimal 0.36. Alright. It's looking for the phenotype ratios, so we're looking for the ratios of non-bald to bald. And in this, we have non-bald is 360 to bald, because it is dominant, 480 because of 160, gives you 640, which is the dominant, so you'll put 360. To 640. So you have 360 to the 640 that had the dominant allele for it, so they have no baldness at all. Look at them. Alright, so when we're looking for allele frequencies, to find the recessive allele for it, we just square root this, square root this, and we get 0.60. So that we have the recessive allele. And since you know the recessive allele is 0.60, then we know that the dominant allele will be 0.40 because that's equal to 1. Now we're looking for the genotype frequencies, so we'll be looking for homozygous dominant. We already have homozygous recessive and the heterozygous. So for homozygous dominant, it'll be BB. For the heterozygous, dominant B, recessive B. And for the recessive, it'll be little B. And we already had that, so we'll have 0.36 there. Now the formula P squared is homozygous dominant, and 2PQ is the heterozygous. Since we have P, we can just square it, and we get our homozygous dominant, and we get 0.16 when you square 0.40 equals.
You know, when
you're
like,
square.
Oh, I don't think, I don't know.
And 0.40 squared gives you 0.16. So, 0.16.
I'm like, no, Peter.
You can see. And for the heterozygous, we just plug in P and Q. Times 0.40 times 0.16. And this gives us 0.48. After doing the math, and then you have all your genotype frequencies, and you know the Audie Weinberg principle.